Did you know that just this year, paleontologists have discovered new insights into the behavior and appearance of Spinosaurus, the biomechanics of Megalodon teeth, and the strangest early lifeforms of the Cambrian Explosion? New revelations are occurring all the time regarding Earth's distant past, yet these incredible findings often go unnoticed by the general public. So, this year, I'm taking part in Paleo Rewind, a breakdown of some of the most important revelations in the field of paleontology from the past year. All sorts of other creators you might already be subscribed to are also participating. In this video, I'll kick the rewind off by covering findings from the first half of January, but be sure to check out everyone else's entries too, and the final 2021 compilation video that will be uploaded on Edge's channel. Now let's get started. Beginning in early January 2021, we have new findings on the potential ecology and feeding behavior of the famous theropod Spinosaurus. The Spinosaurus is a dinosaur that has long gripped popular culture in its elongated jaws, thanks in part to its appearance in the Jurassic Park franchise. But the common conception I grew up with of the Spinosaurus as a bigger, heavier T-Rex analog isn't quite accurate. Indeed, the Spinosaurus has been the subject of considerable recent debate regarding its biology and ecology, as it might have been highly unique from other carnivorous theropods due to its semi-aquatic or perhaps highly aquatic lifestyle. A paper published January 7th by Dr. David Hone and Dr. Thomas Holtz weighs the likelihood of Spinosaurus being a wading animal that fed on fish near the shorelines and in shallow water, or a specialized aquatic pursuit predator. Their studies were quite complex, but to simplify, based on the anatomy of the fossils we have and related ecological data, the wading model is more supported than the highly aquatic one. Still, the authors note that Spinosaurus almost certainly fed primarily from the water and may have swum, which alone might have made it incredibly distinct from most other large theropods. Our next discovery exposes new revelations regarding the history of a highly adapted group of aquatic predators. Sharks. For hundreds of millions of years, sharks of various sizes have been patrolling Earth's oceans, and throughout the Cenozoic, an extinct family known as megatooth sharks started to trend towards gigantism, a trend that culminated in the well-known Megalodon, the largest macropredatory shark to ever exist. This species exceeded lengths of up to 15 meters, or 50 feet, and likely weighed more than 50 tons. But a mystery has long surrounded the Megalodon regarding the nature of their teeth. Compared to the teeth of earlier megatooth sharks, Megalodon teeth consistently had greater crown width, for reasons that aren't entirely clear. Recently, Dr. Antonio Bayel and Dr. Humberto Ferron ran a series of experiments testing the biomechanics of earlier megatooth shark teeth compared to the Megalodon, and the results were quite surprising. It seems stress distribution patterns were remarkably similar across all models, meaning that the teeth of Megalodons, while obviously deadly, weren't any better adapted than the teeth of other sharks in their family. It seems that Megalodon teeth shifted in shape as a byproduct of their gigantism, instead of a specific evolutionary advantage. Still, it wouldn't have been fun to get bitten by one. Winding back the clock by half a billion years, we reached the Cambrian Explosion, a metaphorical eruption in the diversity of early lifeforms, which, as of January 2021, we have new information on. You might already know that the Cambrian Explosion gave rise to countless bizarre lifeforms, many of which seem more like alien life than something from Earth's past. From the surreal Opabinia, which might have possessed a flexible trunk that makes it look almost like a living cartoon, to the Hallucigenia, an animal so dreamlike its name comes from the word hallucination, it's a fascinating early milestone in Earth's biodiversity. In a recent examination by Dr. A.J. Shore and Dr. R.A. Wood unveils a new addition to this pantheon of oddities. Through the analysis of some exceptionally well-preserved fossils, researchers were able to distinguish a lifeform that possessed a cup-shaped skeleton, with six radially arranged lobes surrounding what was likely its mouth. A reconstruction of this lifeform shows it was a highly unique form of animal, and perhaps a foundational member of the Lophotrochozoan clade, a group that today includes various types of cephalopods and mollusks. Sometimes seemingly small discoveries in the realm of paleontology can lead to major revelations. One article from January 6 shows a curious potential relationship between herbivorous dinosaurs and the very plants that they ate. A new examination of fossilized gut contents by Dr. George Perry suggests plant seeds remained intact within the stomachs of plant-eating dinosaurs. Cross-referencing this data with the distances they likely walked, it seems possible that herbivorous dinosaurs dispersed plant seeds far and wide via their, well, droppings. Strange though this might sound, some modern plant munchers, like African bush elephants, play a similar role in the, seed dispersal of certain types of plants. In fact, the dispersal of plant seeds within the bodies of animals is so frequent in current ecosystems that plants often modify their fruits and flowers to appeal more to specific species. And since some dinosaurs could consume even more plant matter per day than elephants, it's likely they were highly sought after seed distributors millions of years ago. A strange but fascinating discovery. And our last article covers a whole new taxon of marine predator, with specialized teeth unlike those of any known reptile. This new taxon is a member of the Mosasaurids, a group of mid-Cretaceous lizards that became specialized for marine life. This exciting new taxon, called Xenodens calmancharii, lived just before the KPG extinction, and stands out from all other Mosasaurids. As reported in the article by Dr. Natalie Bardet and Dr. Nicholas Longrich, this new Mosasaurid possessed teeth that were hooked and formed a saw-like blade. The specialized teeth suggest a previously unknown hunting strategy, likely involving a cutting motion to carve pieces out of large prey. Or perhaps these unique teeth were used for scavenging already deceased marine lifeforms. In either case, these teeth are unique not just among Mosasaurids, but all reptiles in general. And those are just some of the major paleontological revelations of early January. Special thanks to Edge for inviting me to be a part of Paleo Rewind. Other channels like mine will be releasing videos covering other months in the coming days, and I'll add links to them in the description when they upload. And Paleo Analysis is covering the second half of January, so check out their great video next if you want to go in order. And as always, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this entry into the archive, please lend your support, and like, subscribe, and hit the notification icon to stay up to date on all things curious. See you in the next video.